Welcome to EPG Pathshala in the subject of information technology and in the paper of open source software. This is the module about managing software in Linux operating system. So our learning objectives will be, we'll see what is a package, what are the dependencies, how to manage packages, how to install software from various repositories, how to install pre-compiled software like RPM, deb files, etc. And finally, we'll see how to install software from the source code. When we say open source, means the source code is available online. We can download it and install it. So we'll see how to install the software using source code. So let us begin with the discussion. You might have observed that in the previous module, when we were installing Linux operating system, we came across few screens where they asked to install software. If you haven't observed, probably you might have chosen the default custom configuration. So to revisit again, let us see those screens. So when we are installing Linux operating system, we come across screens where the software installation or the modules are shown. For instance, you can see in the screen, we are selecting the base environment as GNOME desktop. This is the installation screen of CentOS operating system, and we select GNOME application, internet applications. We have selected Office Suite. So this is one example how we install software while the operating system, over here it is CentOS. So while the operating system is being installed, we can install software during the installation of OS itself. Let's see another screen. This is the installation screen of Ubuntu server. Again, you can see over here, there are various software applications like DNS server, LAMP, mail server, and so on. So whoever is the system admin will select the particular choices according to their requirement, and then they can continue the installation of Ubuntu system. Let's see one more screen. This is about Debian installation. Again, you can see here, these are the choice boxes. So whenever a system admin wants to install according to his choice, he will tick those particular applications and he can install it. Here we are not installing either of these desktops, GNOME, XFCE, KDE, these are all desktop environments. So the system admin will have choice of selecting either of these desktops, and the system admin can also install as a web server or maybe SSH server and so on. So this is the screen, such kind of screens are available while we install software during the installation of Linux system itself. Now let us see what is a package. Usually any application, it comes in the form of package. Linux distributions, they come with several packages. There are thousands of packages available for different Linux systems. So when we say package, package is a bundle of software, application software that is in executable format. It may contain some other additional things like checksum, like other dependency files and so on. There will be usually a version control file, readme file along with the package itself. So for different Linux operating system, there will be different kind of packages. When we say a package, it is similar to kind of exe file which comes in Windows environment. We can call an exe or a msi file. So what we do in Windows, we download a particular application which is in form of exe, we double click and it gets installed. But in Linux, the picture is somewhat different. As you know, there are various distributions of Linux. So suppose if I am using Red Hat based Linux, probably I won't be able to install the packages that are built for Debian Linux. Or if I am using Red Hat Linux, I can install packages that are created for Fedora or maybe CentOS because they are in the same line of distribution. So installation of package itself is bit challenging while we are using Linux. But as we proceed, we'll see now it has become very easier. There are few very easy commands through which you can locate software, you can locate the packages, and it can install by itself. So when we talk about package management, let's see what is package manager. As you can see in the screen, package manager itself is an application. and the package manager, they have their own repositories. The repository contains metadata and packages. If it is Red Hat based Linux, then RPM are their packages. And for each package, there might be dependencies. So, when we select to install a particular package, we have to download it. Along with the package, the dependencies must also be installed. For instance, suppose I want to install a security package, say for example, nmap, then along with the nmap package, I have to also install those dependencies. So, PMS or package management system, it is a collection of software tools to automate the process of locating a package, installing the package and configuring in this system. Further, we can also delete a package if required, or we can upgrade a package with the help of repository and package managers. So, this is about package manager. Now, when we talk about PMS system, the overall flow of working of PMS system is, suppose if I want to install a software, my query will go to the PMS repository. If I am online, the repository will check a particular mirror website or from where the package is to be downloaded. Then the package will be downloaded from internet, and finally, it will get installed on my system by resolving each and every dependency. So, PMS systems, they automate the task of installing software. To take an analogy, you might have seen the App Store or Play Store in Android. So, when we install any application in Android, simply we select those applications by going into Play Store, we download that application, it gets installed. There is no botheration or there is no technical requirement at the user end side. The same is with Linux operating system. Nowadays, the repositories are almost similar to Play Store. So, a system admin will try to locate the package, it will get downloaded automatically provided the internet is working, and it gets installed on the system. Let us see what is a dependency. Now, when we talk about package, a single package may depend on other packages. You can see the graph over here, there is nmap package. As I said, this is a security tool, it is a well known port scanner tool which is used by security professionals. So, you can see nmap requires all these libraries and some additional packages. So, this is a pcap library for packet capture, you can see SSL library for security purpose, it is secure socket layer, C++ library is there. So, when we install a package, the dependencies must be in our system. If the dependencies are not present in our system, then we won't be able to install this package. So, if a person is layman, he won't be able to resolve dependencies by himself, and that is why Linux has developed an idea of repository. Usually, the system administrator, he fires the command, the package manager will take care of connecting to that repository, finding a package suitable, resolving the dependencies and finally downloading that package. So, the entire task is automated. And as I said, for different Linux system, there are different package managers. For Red Hat based system, there is one kind of package manager. For Debian based system, there is another. Arch Linux, there is one more, and so on. We will try to explore two package managers, that is for Red Hat based distributions and for Debian based distribution or Ubuntu based distributions. As you know, there are various distributions, it is very difficult to cover each and every package manager in detail. So, we will focus on the two widely used Linux distributions in this module. So, when we come to package management system, a package management system can be either graphical user interface or it can be a command line interface. Graphical user interface, it shows the list of software. By simply clicking on that, the system, the software will be installed, provided we have internet connection. Or there is one more option, if we do not have internet connection and if we have a department where there are n number of computers, we can install all the packages in one server from which the clients can access those packages. So, imagine if there are 100 computers, there is no need of each computer downloading a package from internet, we can configure the repository in such a way that instead of connecting to the internet or some mirror site, it will connect to the departmental server from which the packages can be installed. So, for an end user, he may be using either graphical user interface or command line interface. If the person is layman, he might prefer the GUI. It is very simple, and most of the distributions, they come with GUI. For instance, Ubuntu has its own Synaptic Package Manager, or else there are good command line interfaces. So, by simply firing a command, say for example, yum install nmap or apt-get install nmap, the software will be downloaded and installed by itself. One thing that has to be remembered, the account or the login must be super user, so that we get full access or full privileges to install the software in the system. In most of the cases, the software goes in the /usr directory. Going forward, as I said, Red Hat based distributions, they use yum package management tool. Yum is Yellow Dog Update Manager. So, it is a packaging tool which is used by Red Hat, Fedora, CentOS and such kind of distributions. Debian based systems, they use APT package management tool, or we call Aptitude package management tool. Arch Linux is another Linux distribution which uses Pacman package management tool. So, depending on the kind of distribution, we can use a particular package manager. And the commands are also similar. So, there is a yum command, there is apt get command or aptitude command, and there is pacman command if we are using Arch Linux. This screen shows the package manager. This is a GUI screen. You can see there is title Synaptic Package Manager. It is an Ubuntu package manager software. Here there are list of applications. Suppose if I select editors, then the list of softwares or applications for editing purpose will be shown here. Simply by clicking over here and applying, I can install a given software. So, this is a GUI which is very good for layman purpose. It also provides features like searching, filters, etcetera. So, these kind of package managers, they already come with the distribution. If a person is not good in command line interface, he can use this package manager GUI format. Now, let us see each package manager one by one. We will talk about yum first. Yum is used in Red Hat manager. So, when we are using Red Hat based distribution, there is a yum command. We can use yum command in super user mode. We can either query for a package, search for a package, we can install a package, we can upgrade it, we can also erase that package, or we can keep some configuration files and remove that package. So, yum command comes with various options. You can select a particular option, you can search for package. If you are installing a package, the distribution dependencies will be automatically installed by the yum command itself. So, let us take an example of nmap software. Nmap, as I said, it is a port scanner. We can locate or search for nmap. If nmap is in our system, it will display the version number of nmap. We can also install nmap. So, you can see the command is very simple. Just three keywords and the nmap software will be installed. If there is an old version of nmap, we can update it. We can remove the software by keeping the configuration files, or we can completely erase nmap. So, these are few commands which can be tried at the admin level. Now, let us talk about aptitude tool. Aptitude is similar to nmap, but it is used in Debian based distributions like Debian, Ubuntu and so on. Aptitude, it comes in two format. Earlier there used to be apt tool, apt tool, and there later on they created a wrapper called aptitude tool. So, apt tool, it was bit difficult, it was used by technical person, but nowadays we have a wrapper over apt tool which is aptitude, and it is almost similar to yum. So, if we are using Yum in Red Hat based distribution, there is similar aptitude tool for the Debian or Ubuntu based distribution. It does the same thing, locating a package, downloading, installing it, you can upgrade and you can erase those packages. The commands are also almost similar. You can see aptitude also provides a menu driven interface. So, again, this is not a complete GUI, it is a text based menu driven interface, and this is again good for layman users. Aptitude can search for package, install, update, remove and purge. Purge is similar to the erase of the Yum installer. So, earlier days they used apt-get command, but nowadays the administrators are using aptitude command, and it gives a very good interface. There is also a menu driven interface. You can see in the extra reading notes, the screenshots of interface are given, and you can see how easy it is to navigate and install softwares. Now, discussing about package manager, let us see what is Red Hat Package Management, RPM. RPM, they are pre-built binaries. As I said, in Linux, there is something like exe file. Similarly, RPM comes with pre-built binaries. If I do not want to use Yum, I have a choice of downloading the RPM by myself. As I said, Yum will locate it itself, but I do not want those facilities. Then I can download the RPM file, which is pre-built executable file. If it is a GUI, I can double click and install it, or I can give the command rpm-i and I can install that software. But the difficulty with RPM will be, I have to locate each and every dependency. So, if I am downloading nmap and if I do not have the related dependencies installed in my system, then I will end up in installing all the dependencies first, and then I will be able to install nmap in my system. So, RPM is another way of installing. You can find lot of RPM files available over internet. There are websites dedicated which upload RPM files. For each Linux version, there will be a separate RPM file. For instance, CentOS 6 will have RPM for CentOS 6, CentOS 7 there might be a different RPM. So, a technical person may find it suitable, he can find his own Linux and accordingly he can download RPM and install it. So, this is how Red Hat package management can work, and it applies to either of the systems like Fedora, CentOS and so on. These are the commands. If I want to install RPM file, as I said, I have to get the RPM file, nmap, the version number, source.rpm. This is the RPM file, which is a pre-built binary. It is already compiled. I have to use the install option with RPM command, and it will install this RPM on my system. You can see other options as well. We can upgrade, we can erase, we can query for installed software, we can verify, and we can freshen the packages. Some curious users may try to find or try to locate which kind of RPM they are using, then the query option is given. So, with the query option, you can try to find out whether you have the latest version or whether you are using the old version of RPM file. Let us move ahead. When we talk about Debian line of distribution, there is dpkg, or we call dpkg. It is similar to RPM. As we have RPM files in Red Hat Linux, similarly we have dpkg in Ubuntu based or Debian based distributions. The concept is almost similar, but over here there will be deb files, .db files will be downloaded, and the command dpkg will help to install those Debian files. Again, I am repeating, the Debian packages cannot be installed on Red Hat distribution, nor the Red Hat packages can be installed on Debian distribution, provided they are already pre-compiled packages. So, there is a bottleneck. When we are using a particular distribution, we have to download those pre-built packages, then we can use our program. You can see in the screen, this is a sample example how to install particular package. So, when we are using the Debian package tool, there is a deb file, it is for 386 machine. This is the version of nmap software, and by specifying the install option, we can install a Debian package over our Debian-based Linux distribution. Now, when we talk about installing software, there is third alternate to install using the source code. This is a typical programmer's aspect. When we are talking about installing software, when we are talking about open source software, this must be considered. For instance, I download a source code, I have to compile the source code for my machine and then I can install it. So, if I am playing with a small software, it is easy to download the source code and compile it. Naturally, huge applications will take more time in compiling. It may take hours to compile the entire application if it is a low-end machine. But again, for open source programmers, for technical people who want to modify the source code, if they are not satisfied with the source code provided by the application, then they can download the source code, they can modify those source code and they can recompile and install it. So, installing from source code is a more technical aspect. It requires the knowledge of your system, kind of hardware, little bit knowledge. And again, there are set of commands. When we go through those commands, the step by step process will be completed and finally, we can install the software. Again, we will require admin privileges if we are dealing with installing any software, and if it is for all users, then naturally we need super user permissions. So, let us see the steps. What are the steps required in installing open source software? The first step is, we have to download the source code. We have to download the source code of desired application. And in most of the cases, the source code is available in zip format or maybe tar format. There are websites dedicated to upload the source code of a software. Websites like GitHub will have repositories of software. The source code will be available. So, after we download the source code, we have to configure our application. So, this configuration will resolve all the dependencies before installing. And if there is some error, if the dependency is missing, we can see some error message that this dependency is not available and you download and install the dependency first. Once the configuration is over, we can compile the software. Technically, compilation is known as making of the software, or there is a make command to configure the software. And finally, we can install the application. So, let us see each step one by one, how to download, how to configure, the commands related to compiling the software and installing a software. Now, when we download the software, it comes in the form of zip file and usually the extension will be .tar.gz or maybe .tar.zip or .tar.bz2 and so on. There are various compression algorithms. So, whoever has created the software application, they might have used their own compression algorithm. So, if I want to install a software, the first thing is I have to download the source code. Naturally, a source code may have lot of C files, header files and configuration files. So, the bundle of source code, it is known as tarball. Tar is for tape archive. All the files are created bunched together. So, we call it tarball and then we apply zip or compression algorithm. So, we download the tarball. For a technical person, it will be difficult to locate the source code, the correct version. But nowadays, there are GitHub kind of websites available. You can simply search or Google and you can find out the appropriate version. You can find out the history of the software when it was last updated and you can find the relevant version and download it. Again, downloading can be either through browser or through commands like wget and so on. So, let us move ahead. To download a source code, we can use wget command. Source code may be available on the application's website or it may be on GitHub. So, over here we are downloading nmap file, which is tape archived and compression is applied. So, this is the file name nmap-7.40.tar.bz2. will download this file using wget command. Then once the file is downloaded, we have to extract. This is the zip format. So there is a command tar command, and we are extracting. X is for extracting the command. We are extracting this software. Once the software is extracted, it will create a directory. So there will be a directory of nmap. Then we move into that directory. Once we change to this directory, we will see all the source code files. The files of nmap will be visible once we cd into that directory. Now those files will also contain a file like readme or install. Either there can be a readme file or install file. They are all instruction files. So the person who wants to install a software will have to go through the files. Some preliminary description will be given. It will be about configuring the software. So now we move on to the second step. We will have to configure the software. If you are a layman or novice users, you can find out the help for configuration, or else this is how you will configure the software. /- indicates the current directory, and there is a configure command. So there will be a script which runs when we execute the configure command. The configure command will check for dependencies. It will try to resolve each and every dependency. For instance, if I am downloading nmap, then there has to be SSL present in my directory, there has to be a pcap present in my directory, and so on. So those dependencies must be installed if I want to install nmap. Now this checking is done by configure. So whoever is creating source code, they will create a configure file. Before installing software, the system will be configured, parameters will be checked. It may take a minute or so. The script keeps on running for some time. Once you see that configuration is completed, then we can move ahead to the next step. The next step is about compiling the software. So make command is useful for compiling the software. Make will compile all the C files along with the header files, and then you will see the executable files are available. And to install a software, the command is make install. This make install will install the entire software. The software will be placed in particular directory as per the choice or configuration given in the configure file. But for make install, we have to log in as super user, or we can fire this command as sudo. I would recommend to use this command as sudo. So it has to be sudo make install. And if you want to uninstall the software, it has to be sudo make uninstall. And if it's your own system, if it's a home computer, then you can change into root. It has to be a super user login. Hash sign will appear instead of dollar, there will be hash sign, and then you can straight away fire the command make install. So this installation and uninstallation requires super user privileges. Rest of them may not require super user privileges. So this is how we can install open source software. We have to download it, we have to configure, compile, and finally install that software. Once the software is installed, how we launch the application? If it's a GUI, probably you can see the graphical user interface, or you can simply type nmap and the tool starts running. And if you know the directory where it was installed, then you can go to that directory. It can be usr local bin, and you can fire this nmap command. You can know the version, you can get more information about nmap by going into that directory as well as from your current directory also. So launching of application, if it's a GUI, as I said, there will be a icon available on your desktop, or if it is a command line interface, command line application, then you will find the commands available to almost all users. So over here, nmap will be available to any user if it's installed in that particular access privileges environment. So let us summarize what we discussed in this module. We started our discussion about installing a software. So when we install Linux, there are provisions available to install the software along with Linux installation. Somehow, if we have missed that train, then there are other options. There are package managers through which you can install particular application by selecting a package manager. It can be a GUI or it can be command line. By using package manager, we can download the packages, we can download dependencies, and it can be installed. And if you are a software programmer, you want to rebuild the software or you want to play with the source code, then the last way is you can download the source code, what we call tarball. We can extract, we can compile, and finally we can install it on our system. So please go through the reading notes. I have provided the pointers to downloading of software. You can go through those, you can try to download it. If you wish, you can also configure your repositories, and please try to install at least 2-3 applications to get a little bit confidence. I hope you enjoyed this session. Thank you. Then we'll see how to install software and manage software using repositories. We'll see how to install software and manage software using already built packages.